Bunyoro is home to the Albertine Graben, where oil depots were discovered and various activities by oil companies, Total Energies and CNOOC Uganda, are underway to produce Uganda's first oil by 2025. While speaking during the Supplier Development Conference organized by CNOOC Uganda, small and medium enterprises expressed concern that ever since oil development started in the area, they have not benefited much.
The policies that are required are too many. And you find that the small and medium enterprises, the staff they have may not be able sometimes to handle those requirements. So you find that sometimes you see the advert, you do expression of interest, but even you don't know how these contracts are awarded. We come here in the meetings, you hear tier this has been awarded to this, tier this has been awarded. Then for you, as a small and medium enterprise, you have to look for those people who have won the contracts under certain tiers so that you now engage them.
My request was, it is about the contractors. Contractors should come up and consider the local content people so that they can benefit in their what? In this business. But if they consider big companies, we are going to make a total loss. Thereby, we don't have the capacity to deal with the big companies. So ours are small, and even the suppliers of our products are there. But you may find even the big people have started to get the products, and you find when the market has been taken by what? The big people.
Business owners Fred Musingzi and David Ayebare lament that there is a lot of bureaucracy in registering with the National Supplier Database.
The challenge, one, is getting to register on the National Supplier Database. It's a long hurdle, a lot of bureaucracy, especially for companies that have been in existence for some time. There is a lot of paperwork to do. Secondly, the system itself does not guarantee that you'll be there in an instance. A number of things keep missing, you keep coming back until you get it right.
We are lacking information and we are lacking capital to execute these contracts. And of course, the standard, as I've told you, the international standard required by all companies. Most of us here, oil is new, so we can't meet the standard unless we are trained and we are being empowered by these oil companies.
Zakalia Lubega, the corporate affairs manager at CNOOC Uganda, has reiterated that all those who hope to do business in the sector must first register.
I encourage everyone to get to the PAU, certainly as a custodian of the National Supplier Database, get the information, be guided, work with your colleagues to support you, and I suppose there is no competition between the different business entities, because most of you are focusing in different directions. So if Mr. Fredo is in media services, somebody is in hotel, Mr. Fredo should come out and support someone else who is in another entity.
Matthew Charlie Gonza, the National Content Manager, CNOOC Uganda, urged the Bunyoro business community to collaborate with agencies that have strong financial capacities, saying it will help them get contracts easily.
We have unbundled packages in EPCs, EPC 1 up to 4, and other smaller packages to make sure that the scope of work, which was formerly very complex, is scaled down to ensure that these smaller companies are able to participate. We are also encouraging our main EPC contractors to do subcontracting of the smaller packages to the other companies that don't have the capacity to do the bigger packages. So the subcontracting strategy is also helping us to ensure that more Ugandans actually participate.
To register with the National Supplier Database, companies must provide information on proof of legal status and legal name, good market conduct, good liquidity status, compliance with taxes and social security requirements, and valid bank reference, as well as authentic, valid and up-to-date shareholding and management of the company or entity. Individual consultants are required to provide a proof of nationality, tax registration and expertise, a valid national identification card or a valid passport for Ugandan citizens, valid alien identification card or a bio page for a valid passport for non-Ugandans, and industry accreditation certificates, if any. Story compiled by Ambrose Niwagawa Katoto for the news.